Hey guys, Courtney here. We are going to talk about essential oil application 101. So, how do you use these oils, right? You got all these little bottles and you're like, what do I do with them? So, let's talk about that today. So, the first way to use the essential oils that you guys would be the number one that everybody would assume would be direct inhalation. So, breathing the oils in. So, aromatherapy 101, smell the oils. Now, there's going to be some that maybe you don't necessarily like the smell, but there's certain oils that really just smelling them is going to get to that part of your brain within just a few seconds to help boost your mood, to help with that, some of that focus and mental clarity and things like that, just by smelling the oils. So research shows that inhaling the pure constituents that are in the oils can stimulate your olfactory receptors and activate the regions in the brain's limbic system that are associated with your memory, your emotion, and just like your overall state of mind. So in less than a second, a scent has the power to activate a number of physical and emotional responses. So this causes your pituitary gland to be stimulated and release the chemical messages that travel throughout your body to create these physical body responses. So that is why inhaling the oils can have such a great effect on your emotions, because the only way to reach that part of your brain is through your nose instead of where a lot of things could be taken orally. So, for like emotional distress or nervousness, you can even like take a couple drops, put it on your hand, and just breathe it in, breathe it in like that. And even just taking the bottle and smelling it, I've actually been where I started feeling kind of uneasy when I was out somewhere and I felt like I was gonna faint almost. And I took one of my oils and I was like taking deep breaths, like just to try to like clear whatever was going on, and it helped. So, definitely smelling the oils, number one, nice and easy. So, the next way to use the oils is going to be topically. So, you can put it on your skin. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that some of the oils are considered to be hot oils. So, what hot oil means is that they're super, super strong. So, some hot oils on like oregano is one, for example, that if you just put oregano straight on your skin, it can start to feel like really hot, like almost a burning sensation. And it's not burning you, but it just feels like so hot that you want to use some sort of a carrier oil to dull that down a little bit, dull that sensation down. So, different carrier oils you can use. Young Living has this V6 oil. You can use coconut oil, olive oil, grapeseed oil, almond oil are some different ones that people use as a carrier oil to just dilute. I like to dilute stuff anyway. I like to make roll-ons. Some oils I like to keep at 100%, but other ones, like when I'm making my perfumes and stuff, I add a few drops of oil and then I add a carrier oil. And a carrier oil is going to be the first thing that you're going to go to if an oil is feeling hot. If you go and try to like wash it off with water, it might almost like intensify it. So when that happens, you just want to take a little bit. So if you put something on and you're having a little sensitivity, just put a little bit of this carrier oil and kind of rub it in, and that'll help to dull that down. So now, in regards to putting it on topically, because of their tiny molecular structure, essential oils are rapidly absorbed in your skin. So applying the oils to your feet is an awesome way to absorb these oils into your body. If you are familiar with VitaFlex points at all, if not, use the good old Google and Google VitaFlex points, and you'll see that there are points all over your feet that are connected to your different body systems. So let's say if you needed some digestive support, then you could place the oil on your stomach, or you could place the oil on your foot and the VitaFlex point that directly represents your stomach as well. So the bottoms of your feet have some of the largest pores on your body and don't usually have as much sensitivity as some other areas on the body. So some people prefer to put oils on their feet because maybe they're really sensitive to the smell, but they just need peppermint to help support something, so they put the peppermint on the bottoms of their feet so that they can gain the benefits, but they don't have to smell it constantly. So, but other places you can put it on topically, like if you're needing skin support, obviously you would kind of like put it wherever you're needing that support. But you can also put, I do it a lot on my wrists. If I'll put an oil on my wrists and rub it together, especially Valor, that's one of my favorites. Sometimes I'll put them on my hands and just kind of rub it like this. If I just am using like an emotional support oil that I just want to smell and I kind of use that as my perfume, you can, put oils kind of around your ears, but I do not put oils in the ears. We'll get to that in another video about like the do nots of essential oils, but don't put oils in your ears. You can, there are also Vitaflex points on your ears as well as there are on your feet. So different places in your ears correlate with different parts of your body. But do not put the oils in your ears. I cannot stress that enough. But you can put them on your temples, up and down your spine, like and over your heart. One of my favorites to put on my heart, Joy Oil. Joy Blend is just amazing, and I put the Joy right on my heart, and I just love it. So that's kind of one of my go-tos. You can also bathe with the essential oils. I will say do not use any of the hot oils, oregano, wintergreen. Certain oils are going to be pretty uncomfortable. Do not use the Panaway blend. I think I've heard from people in the bath, or at least use a lot of it. You'll want to put some Epsom salts and stuff. I always mix my oils with Epsom salt in the bath, as well as a little bit of carrier oil when I'm taking a bath. And I mix them before. I mix the oils in the Epsom salt and then pour it into the bath so that it kind of disperses the oil a little bit. So couple tips. You can apply 1 to 2 drops of an oil directly onto the desired area. For digestive support, you can put the essential oils on your belly, or you can put it on your chest, or you can do it on the Vitaflex points, like I was saying. For respiratory support, you can put a little bit like Raven oil, for example, ones that are for and RC. You can put a tiny bit, and you put in a little bit of carrier oil, but you can put a little bit right here, like in your sinus area, if you're having any like inflammation or stuff, or you need some respiratory support. Or you can just put on your chest, like you guys know the stuff that smells like eucalyptus, starts with a B, that a lot of us grew up on putting on our chest and it was all goopy. Well, you can make that yourself. No need to go get stuff with added ingredients. You get some, Young Living has eucalyptus oil, or they also have a handful. They got the Breathe Again Roll-On. There's the Sniffle Ease for kids is an amazing blend, even for adults. RC, Raven, like those are all awesome for respiratory support and stuff that you can mix with carrier oil and put on your chest if you need some breathing support. So next way is going to be to diffuse the oils. So if you have a premium starter kit, then you would have received a diffuser as well. So I've got my little diffuser set up right here. So that is going to be like one of the main ways and the easiest ways, I think, for people to start integrating oils. A lot of what I hear from some of my new members is like the first thing they do is plug in their diffuser. And even if you're super confused about what other oils to use, like throw some lemon in your diffuser, or throw some frankincense or some lavender, or maybe even put a drop of each in there. But it's really fun to kind of mix and match and see what you like in the diffuser. Peppermint, lemon, lavender, fruity. I love to do citrus stuff like citrus fresh or just orange oil, lemon oil. Some of my favorites, and a lot of the emotionally uplifting oils are great if you just need it. Christmas spirit, I love to diffuse that blend all through the holidays. So you can check out my website too, and just look up diffuser recipes and you'll see them all over too. Some different recipes that you can try that help to support. When we like seriously need like yucky time of year support, we're like diffusing thieves oil in every room pretty much. So those are going to be like the main ways, is going to be direct inhalation and topically. So the last one we're going to get to is internal use. So Young Living specifically has a line. You guys have seen on these oils that have the little Vitality right there. So Young Living specifically started the Vitality line so that it was very clear as to what oils were specifically meant for internal use. There's maybe other oils that aren't in the Vitality line that some people have used internally, but the ones that you're going to see labeled as Vitality is just to really easily identify so that you know that these are specifically for internal. So you're going to find like a group of the citrus oils, orange, lemon, grapefruit, lime, citrus fresh. Those are all going to be Vitality in like the citrus Vitalities. And then you have like the cooking Vitalities like basil and nutmeg and different ones. Dill. You've got dill Vitality oil. So there are a lot of different oils that are specifically meant for you for internal. And just to keep it straight, Vitality oils are the same oil. So a bottle of lemon is the exact same oil as a bottle of lemon Vitality. But you're going to notice that the bottom of bottle of lemon says for aromatic and topical use, and that the bottle for lemon Vitality will say that that is the one that's for internal use. Even though they're both the same exact oil, there is absolutely no difference between the two bottles. It's just keeping compliant and helping you guys to really identify which ones, especially for your new oilers and you're just not sure, like, which ones can I put in my water and what can I do? Go to the Vitality line and you're going to see that. So thank you guys so much. Hope I helped you out. Let me know if you have any questions. Please like my video, follow my page, all the good stuff, and hope you have a great day.